Welcome back to the Napa Valley Tournament Expert Division opening round. Hole number five. Here we're going to be setting up for a sniper slash cat double bounce rough bump using a P5, a side spin 1 plus wind 3 plus ball. For the best chance at the drop, I do recommend a 5-1-5 ball. Power 5, wind 5. That's what most of my practicing was done with. However, I did practice this with a luminary type ball. It can be played with a wind 3. We're going to start. The adjustment is P5 plus 10 max. No moving target. And we're using 4.7 top spin and 1 left spin. What I can tell you here is that if you're using a luminary and you have a king wind, right, you probably don't want to use 4.7 topspin. You know, you might want to back that down to 4.5. No overpower, half a ball left curl. We do have some room on the top here, and I did, like I said, I did practice this with the luminary. I never caught the king wind with the luminary. I did have some winds in the high sevens, low eights, and they were safe, but they were kind of close to the rough on the top. So anything, I would say this, anything 8.5 or above, I would definitely back off of the top spin to at least 4.5. Just to make sure it's safe. Rather be safe than sorry. We don't want to walk away from this one with a birdie. Worst case scenario, we want an easy eagle. And best case scenario, we walk away with the albatross. So just keep that in mind. High winds, back off your top spin a little bit so you don't run long. For the second shot, now this is why I say sniper or cat, because with the sniper, I'm using max top spin, 6.1 top and 1 left. If you're using a sniper 9, you're not going to have enough top spin. So, but you can play the same shot with cat 5 plus. You'll just be playing it with cat numbers and cat plus yard numbers, right? As it stands, I'm using sniper and sniper plus yards. Or you can still use the sniper. You just may have to push it up. I don't know if sniper 9 would have enough top spin to do the double bounce rough bump. I mean, you probably got, what, like 4.5 top spin versus my 6.1. So if you're playing it with a sniper 9, you might not be able to get to the double bounce rough bump, but you can still reach the hole. You can bounce over with a little bit of backspin, and instead of playing the rough bump, just play the bounce up with the sniper if you don't want to play it with the cat. For the approach shot, P5 minus 15% at slider. Again, I'm using max top 1 left with a sniper 10 here, which is 6.1 top 1 left. So if you're using, you know, cat, that's what I would recommend. That this top spin seems to work good and land pretty consistent. With spin added, you want to have the second bounce in the rough and the tip of the ball guide just through the back center, or through the center of the cup, just through the hole, just barely through the hole, or at least to the back of the cup. Also here, I pulled this one with too much 1159. Now you're gonna, actually this one I don't, on my live shot I pulled it with too much 59. So make sure you're pulling it straight with just a baby 59 flicker You don't want to put too much 59 on it, or you're going to miss it just right like I did when I played it live. So, straight, slight 1159 flicker, not much. That's basically just making sure we're not pulling any 01, and we're pulling mostly straight, all right? The only other thing to note here to give yourself a better chance at dropping this albatross is there are some wind angles that will require you to add a little bit of OP. And how I'm determining whether or not I need OP is based on the plus yards that I start at and adjust to. So I start at the plus 5. The typical adjustment that doesn't need any OP is going to be 2 plus yards higher or less. So if I adjust up to the plus 7 or the plus 6, or I stay at the plus 5, then I don't need any OP. But if I start at the plus 5 and I adjust up to the plus 8, then I'll need 2 clicks of OP. So everything above 2 from where you're starting at, I recommend 2 clicks of OP. So if you start at the 5, you adjust up to the 8, 2 clicks of OP. If you adjust up to the 9, 4 clicks of OP, right? 2 is the base. If you adjust only up 2 plus yards, that's good. You don't need any OP. And that's what I do here. So no overpower. No curl, only a little bit of OP if you catch the headwind angle. Besides that, this one's been coming in pretty consistently for, you know, given what it is and what we're doing. A decent chance at dropping the albatross here. Worst case scenario should be easy eagle for you, all right? Very safe, very easy eagle with a good shot at dropping it. Practice it a couple of times. Hopefully you walk away from hole 5 with the Albie. P5 plus yards for the sniper, all right? 0 is 45, 1 is 47, 2 is 50, 3 is 52, 4 is 55, 5 is 57, 6 is 60, 7 is 62, 8 is 65, 9 is 67, plus 10 is 70 slider. 11 is 72, 12 is 75, 13 is 77, 14 is 80, plus 15 is 82, 16 is 85, 17 is 87, 18 is 90, 19 is 92, 20 is 95, 21 is 97, 22 is 100. That's sniper plus yards, P5 numbers. If you happen to be playing this with a cat, I'm going to give you those numbers as well. Cat plus yard P5 numbers, 0 is 55, 1 is 57, 2 is 59, 3 is 61, 4 is 63, 5 is 65, plus 6 is 67, 7 is 69, 8 is 71, 9 is 72, 10 is 74, 11 is 76, 12 is 78, 13 is 80, 14 is 82, 15 is 84. You shouldn't need any more than that. Good luck, everyone. Hope y'all get the drop, and we'll see you on the next one.